Salutări și bine v-am găsit la un nou zbor, nou livestream de pe acest canal. Astăzi vom zbura, vom face un zbor ceva mai interesant. Va fi odată cu începerea sezonului, cu ziua de 1 aprilie și cu începerea sezonului estival, să spun așa, în unele țări, mai exact în Egipt, vom zbura din București către Hurghada, vom duce niște români în Egipt. Bine, nu știu dacă sunt numai români, mă rog, ați înțeles ideea. Vom duce niște pasageri către Egipt să se bucure de un concediu în Hurghada, în Egipt. Acum începe sezonul în Egipt, pentru că e destul de cald și e lejer acest început de prin aprilie. Deja în iulie-august e mult prea cald ca să mergi în Egipt. Am, spun din propria experiență, am fost în Egipt în august și e mult prea cald. Efectiv, la amiază nu puteam să stau afară, simțeam că leșin, efectiv. Dar, da, a fost ok oricum. Dar atât timp cât stai la umbră, e bine, la, vreau să zic, aproape la orice temperatură, dar nu e chiar așa. Mă rog, suntem aici cu livery-ul celor de la Anima Wings. Anima Wings este o companie care face acest zbor București-Otopeni ca un tip, un zbor charter, ho-ho. Hai că da, Matei, vezi că te-a făcut Bianca. La mine apare Bianca prima. Târziu, la mine apare Bianca prima. Despre ce vorbește, să-mi și poză, ești nebun. Contează ce apare la streamer, că la tine tu apari prima. Exact, în același timp, numai că Bianca a fost puțin mai rapidă. Bianca au fost. Am încercat să reproduc exact și ora la care va zbura acest avion. Va decola undeva la 7 și ceva din București. Deci acum e 6:30, dacă nu mă înșel, e destul de întuneric. Și da, haideți să nu mai pierdem timpul și să intrăm în cockpit, să punem aici tot ce trebuie. Punem bateriile. Aliniem, stați, era să fac o prostie, mai întâi trebuie să fac ceva. Nu, deci vorbesc serios, vă fac și poze și vă arăt, adică chiar Bianca o scris prima. Îi dăm reel, asta le-am dat deja pe reel, ok. Credeam că am uitat să fac eu o setare, bun, dăm IRS-urile pe nav. Nav, ground control, crew supply, strobe lights pe auto. Navigation, seatbelts, no smoking și emergency exit lights. Perfect. Schimbăm astea. Dăm puțină lumină acum, chiar dacă imediat va răsări soarele și se va face lumină. Și nu vom mai avea nevoie de atâta lumină. Măcar acum să fie așa mai luminat. Bun. Trecem și în MCDU. ASUS, AOC, any data request. Eu cred că a zis de tine așa că glumiți de tine. Aia, Matei. Nu facem glumițe de genul ăsta. Am presiunea destul de mică în București. 997 de milibari. Micuță standard de 1013, dacă nu mă știu, da, 1013. Bun. Haideți să începem și refuel-ul. Avem nevoie de 8254. Dacă am 6 minute refuel-ul, numai bine. Să luminăm și astea puțin. Așa. Weight and balance. Avem un total de 166 de pasageri și putem începe boarding-ul. Stați să văd cam la ce volum e dat simulatorul, cred că e undeva la 50%, da, 40 chiar. Se dă puțin mai tare. Așa. Perfect. Așteptăm să se îmbace și pasagerii, dăm aici un init request. Ce... 8254. Deci 8.25 ar veni 8.3. Un average 266-65. Deci un head de 65. Din păcate un head nu trei. Head 65. S-ar putea acest headwind să ne încurce puțin, să ne întârzie puțin, să sperăm că nu totuși. Flight plan. Vom lua IDAR, one mic departure, ok? Nu suntem pe VATSIM, deoarece nu e absolut niciun controller și chiar fiind un zbor ceva mai lung, nu vreau să-mi pice live-ul sau ceva. Și V-Pilot-ul mai băga câteva, un procesor stres, să zic așa. Și chiar nu voiam. 997, Aidan, 997. Bun. Așa. Socot 1 Alpha la arrival. 34 right. ALS 34 right, Socot 1 Alpha. N-avem niciun. What? What? Really? Și nici dacă e de mai nav. Nici dacă îi dăm orice altceva. 34 RNF 16 LED, de exemplu. Ceea ce n-avem? Nu. Interesant. Arrival-ul probabil nu o să respectăm. Iată, din cât nu e în MCD, nu știu de ce nu e, dar mă rog. Bun. Pornim constraint-urile, că vom avea nevoie de ele. Așa, să-i dăm la OFB. Să dăm la Winds. Mamă, câte avem aici samba picioare. Bun. Climb, prima dată. Climb wind 231.40, 231. De ce sună Mozart melodia asta care e pe fundal? 228.62. De ce cred că e Mozart? Așa, și 222.86 la 350. Bun, next phase cruise. Hai să dăm un vânticel așa mai de pe aici, un de la AIT. 253.58. Ba nu, hai să dăm mai aproape aici. 286.104. 286.104. Interesant. 370. Și 289.123. Wow. 289. O să avem parte de niște rafale, să spun așa. Bun, și la descent. Hai să-i dăm 311.99. 311.99. 390. Este 98 23 200. 304 14 150. Și la 100 211.4 211 That's perfect. Am pus și vânturile aici, hai să vedem că nu avem niciun discontinuity. Op, aparent nu avem nimic, ceea ce e foarte bine. Este Istanbul, poate Fatih. Sunt acolo niște waypoint-uri turcești. Bun. Ce mai putem face? Ne uităm. Ațu, AOC media. Să vedem pasageri, 73 doar, din 166. Uităm și la chart-uri, puțin. Nu s-a aliniat și aia RS aparent. Așa arată departure-ul nostru. Am... se pare mi s-o e ceva în regulă aici. A, cred că ăsta e... What? Aba, nu arată bine, cred că e buguit. Da, e buguit nevo. Nu știu ce are. Da, chart-urile. Cam asta va fi ruta, o vom lua. Vom ieși fix aici despre Constanței prin Mangalia. Vom lua de-a lungul Mării Negre. După care vom trece deasupra Istanbulului. Vom avea Istanbul în partea stângă și dreapta, da, mai mult stânga. După care vom coborâ spre Antalya. În Antalya vom trece Marea Mediterană și vom intra în Egipt prin ce aici? Baltim Resort. Ah, ok. Un resort ceva. Bun. Să vom trece deasupra Cairo-ului, iar aici vom ateriza în Hurghada. Interesant, Soco 1 Alpha ăsta, hai să ne uităm la el puțin. Da, nu știu. Nu știu de ce nu mi-apar chestiile astea, sincer. Și chiar sunt curios cum apare la final. Haideți să ne uităm. Cam pe aici, pe undeva. Bun, și conștient că trebuie să zbor deasupra la ci asta, nu? Da, un arrival interesant, nu prea respectă chart-ul, dar vedem noi ce o să facem acolo. Cruising altitude 390. De timp putem face și niște checklist-uri. Garand pins removed, fuel quantity is acquired, seatbelts on, ADS to nav și baro reference 0997. Dăm înapoi arc. Așa. Mai uităm la chart-ul puțin. Principal asta la București. Vom decola de pe 26 right. Deci vom lua India, Mike, Sierra, November, Oscar. India, Mike, Sierra, November, Oscar. departure urile dimineața sunt de pe 26 right și seara de pe 08 left. Și aterizările pe pista opusă. Din câte știu eu, acum s-ar putea să mă îndoiesc. Bun. Vom lua pe 8 open 661, maxim 210 noți. Open 667, maxim 270 de noți, dar n-avem, înțeleg că n-avem restricție la 250. N-avem restricție de viteză, aparent. Ceea ce e curios. Dar bun. Asta e și chart-ul. Chart-ul nostru. Vom avea o leacă de străbătut, dar va fi interesant zbor. N-am mai zburat în zona aia până acum. Chiar sunt curios, n-am zburat nici spre Turcia, dacă stau să mă gândesc. Deci ce aș vrea să fac la un moment dat, un zbor spre Istanbul. Ăștia sunt imediat curios cum văd pasageri. Pasagerii sunt undeva pe aici. Cam așa, hop. Asta trebuie să fie otopeniu. Și e așa, vă, ce că... Da, nu se vede chiar așa. Nu se vede chiar așa, dar... Să zicem că așa se vede. Începe să răsară și soarele, vom avea take-off-ul perfect, să spun așa. Bun. Gata și refueling-ul, din cât te pot imagina, apanul 0.5 minute care fiu. Ok, nu știu de ce mai avea acolo super puțin. Pornim the pumps. Începem ușor să dăm drumul și la APU. Flap open, punem APU.
As they review the safety operations of this Airbus aircraft. We do appreciate your business having aboard this flight. If there's anything we do to make your flight any more enjoyable, please don't hesitate to ask. Welcome aboard.
Bun, putem... Baba, nu, încă nu chemăm... Încă nu chemăm... pe șeful. Am așa, 320. AMI-500, wind component 212 knots, deci vine, da, un tail ar veni, da, lăsăm așa, îl suntem 24 de grade. Ai de capul meu și în Hurghada 30. QNH10, no, less than and then 8 takeoff weight. No, no, dai. 52 flexul, ok. .7 avem acolo. Ok. 57 /up 0.6. Și vitezele sunt acestea. Transition altitude e bun. Totul e bun. Haideți să chemăm și pushback tacul. Pushback tacul, nu tacul, de ce zic tacul? Bun. Beacon.
Flight attendants, arm doors, and cross check.
Back on big set, deco speeds, and thrust is set, windows start closed, beacon is on. Engine mode to ignition și putem pune motorul cu numărul 2. Bun, setting engine number 1. engine number on is available. Engine selected to normal. Așa. Cut off the APU bleed. Runway turn off lights on. Nose lights to taxi. Here, let's tune in the transponder. Let's write in a random number. Close the door. It should have been closed, but who cares? Okay. Everything is set here. Okay, flaps 1. And the spoilers. Auto brake to max. Flight controls full down. Full up. Full left. And full right. Rudder right. And rudder left. Perfect. After start checklist, MTS is set. ECAM status is checked. Base trim is checked. And rudder trim is in neutral. And now we can do the taxi checklist as well. Flight control is checked. Flaps setting on config, radar, and prediction on and auto. Engine mode selected normal. ECAM memo takeoff no blue. Perfect. It is takeoff no blue. Except for the cabin. Okay. Great. Everything is set here as well. Right. Let's just engage the parking brake and let's go taxi. We will taxi via India, Mike Sierra Oscar November Oscar, if I'm not wrong. India Mike Sierra November Oscar, exactly. I'm too good. Too good. And the sun. It's the sunrise as well, so beautiful. I will never get tired of this game. Only when I'll start flying real airplanes, that's the only moment when I will get tired of Microsoft Flight Simulator. This is auto pen airport. Can you put the time on real time? No, I cannot. Because I want to simulate the real flight of the real flight time of this flight. Which says that the departure is at 7 AM. And if I wanted to, I would have put the real time from the beginning. It's morning. It will be starting to get bright. To see the desert in Egypt, it will be that. Don't think there are any flights during the day, at least from Romania to Egypt. All the flights are during the day, not during the night. So because that's how I guess that's how hotels work. You gotta check in at the hotel during the day. I mean, no, it doesn't matter. You can check in during the night as well. Because I checked during the night. We arrived pretty late in Hurghada last summer. How about a first officer takeoff? First officer point of view. What do you think about this? How far away are we from the end of the runway? We are only at the half. Okay, we are getting close to the runway. We might start braking a bit. Change our camera. Landing lights will go on. Nose lights to taxi.
Please prepare for takeoff.
Hello Habakkuk, hello, welcome to the livestream. You've came at the right moment. Okay. Lineup, checklist, takeoff runway, TKS and PAX will go off in just a moment. PAX are off. Okay. Totals to 40%. This thing is the parking brakes and flex. Landflex 52, the southern runway. Tot asta e zblenat. That nuts. Ivan, rotate. Positive rate gear up. That's the rest of the plan. Why are you sitting in the right seat? Because I just randomly change to this seat when I was taxiing to the runway. I was like, hey, let's do a right seat takeoff, why not? Let's be first officers. Flaps clean, disarm the spoilers. Yes, I know. Flex 1 and 2 are coming back on. QNH standard. Would you look at that? Okay, 5,000 feet. Autopilot 1 is coming on. Runway 10 off, lights off, nose lights off as well. FlyLive Studio is bugged as usual. 10,000 feet. Landing lights are coming off. Wow, such a view. And seatbelt signs off. Turn the volume down a bit, just a bit. Guess I'll fly to Hurghada also today on a flight simulator, or do you fly on next plane, or do you fly in real life? Don't know what you're referring to. Hello, I noticed that the 777 for Captain Sim has very rigid controls, meaning when I do a little to the right, it shows itself to the right. I don't know how to fix this issue. It seems like a problem related to your controller or whatever you use, a side stick, a yoke or whatever you use. It seems like a calibration issue, and you might want to look into the settings of your controller or your whatever you're using. Personally, I didn't try the 777 because a lot of people told me that it's not really optimized. And yeah, I actually don't know how to give you a straight answer, but this might be an issue, something with the calibration. Just look into it. Try a lot of different methods, you know, and I guess in the end you'll find out. What plane is this? This is an Airbus A320. It's an Airbus A320. It's Anima Wings is a Romanian company, a Romanian charter company. But it also has some flights. You can Google Anima Wings. This route Bucharest to Hurghada has launched like 1 week ago, and it's a daily route from Bucharest to Hurghada. And yeah, because the season, the don't know how to call it in English, but the going to the beach season has started in Egypt. The estival season, it's in Romanian, I don't know if in English is the same thing. The going to the beach season has started in Egypt, and there's a lot of demand for Egypt and especially for Hurghada, and that's why this company has chosen. But yeah, this is an A320 Neo to be more specific. Let's try a first officer view with this. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Guys, make sure to press the like button and also subscribe to the channel if you like the content. I will write a comment to pin it. Welcome everyone. Make sure to press the like and subscribe. Thank you, Vian Kumar, I hope. Vian Kumar, I don't know how to pronounce it. Vian Kumar, that's how I pronounce it. Okay, we have a an interesting route here. Let's go direct to Numti, because this will shorten our way a lot. Numti direct. It will shorten our route a lot. And we will also get this beautiful wing view, but off to our left side. Wow. Wow.
just reached our cruise
Thank you. Thank you.
Hello everyone, I am back in the cockpit, preparing our descent into Hurghada. We will have to open some programs here for the landing. Okay, perfect. Turn the volume up a bit. Okay, that's on. Make sure we turn in this program as well. FlightRecorder, which is the replay program. We are over the Egyptian desert. Yeah, nothing much to see here. We are 169 nautical miles away from Hurghada. Let's introduce, actually let's get a meter and you see whether perfect, get a meter for my tail shot. Have some turbulences, let's turn this on. Company message. Meter. Print. Alrighty, now QNH will be 1012. At Hurghada, temperatures are 34 degrees. Solid wind 0 at 0. No winds. Interesting. And the barrel reference was 289 or 86, I think. Somewhere around that. Actually, yeah, our top of descent is way too high. Bumpy here. Whoa, why is it so bumpy? What the hell? Six votes and only 12 likes. Congrats, guys. Minus 24 appreciations. It's that or I have 24 dislikes. Okay, I think we can start our descent now.
As you may have noticed, we have begun our initial descent down to our destination. Now would be a good time to wrap up any business you need to take care of as we prepare for approach. If you are up, once you return to your seat, we ask that you remain seated until the aircraft arrives safely at the gate. Flight attendants, please prepare the cabin for a ride.
Wing view left, please. Okay, sir, as you wish. Came here to see the dessert. Yeah, I mean this view is also nice, but okay, let's give it a wing view. I have this view. Schneider Ramirez, hello, welcome to the live stream. I have this one. Yeah, this one's better. Hello guys, welcome. You've came at the right moment. The descent. When I was there, the mountains were bigger in my eyes. Well, it's a game and it might not get the height of the mountains exactly right. And this looks like a picture to me. It seems like a flat with just a picture. I don't know. Don't know. I've also been there, but I don't remember the mountains exactly. And I was there pretty recent, in August last year. Yep, we are doing the ILS for the 34, right? We have it here. It's the only runway with an ILS, so. And as far as I know, planes are only landing on 34, right? Or no, I think I've landed on 16 left once. I can't remember exactly. But yeah, 34 right now. I had to download a mode for this airport because the other runway, the 34 left and 16 right, didn't show as a runway. It showed as gravel and sand. Don't know why. Probably because it's recently built, or don't know. Out of curiosity, let's watch the traffic on VATSIM, because I'm curious if there would have been any traffic. Nope, there wasn't. Actually, there was a plane that was about to come and land. Would have been interesting to see him. I think we'll enter a hold at Sokot just to be sure that that we'll make everything, because we're pretty high. So I'll go, or actually Octave. No, we've gone past Octave. So we will go to Sokot and hold. Time and distance, yeah, that's fine. Actually, there was something related. Standard menu, no, not this. The star, Hurghada out of fixed holding procedures. Fly level 120 at Bob. Bob, we don't have that. Let's check Sokot overlay. Yeah, both fly level 110 at Sokot. Above 110, so we will go down to 110 and enter a hold at Sokot instead. Because we descended a bit too late, and just to make sure that we'll make everything. And just like that, we added some track maps. You'll go back or finish after this? No, I'll finish. I will do a Hurghada Bucharest, but another time, probably next week, to do kind of a role play, you know, to simulate these people going back to their home. Set hold speed. Oh, okay. Oops. Sorry. No, actually, just go. Go away to 75 and then we'll set the speed. we won't go back because it's it will take us some time, and also I have a concert at 6 in 2 hours, so 2 hours and a half. And I wouldn't finish. Where is the airport? Look, the mountains look bigger now. Well, at least they look. And the airport is there, right? Yeah. But I can only see one runway. Why is that? Interesting. Set home speed. Where should I? To 30, as the charts say, at Sukkot we have to be at 230. Max 230 below 110, so Sukkot is at 110. That means we need to be at maximum 110. 230. And at flight level 115 we will call an immediate exit, but actually let's call it now. Sorry.
At least now we are at the correct altitude. The hell up. Brake to low, passing 10,000, landing lights, anything else here, 34 right, ILS 34 right, I think we will actually vector ourselves, because yeah, this plan doesn't look right. But let's get a little bit closer to the airport. And I can still see only one runway, but at least it's the one we are landing on. Didn't the mod apply, or what happened? Dun 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 dun. No, it did. What the fuck happened? Anyway, let's set ourselves 161. Oh, the airport is a little bit far. A little bit further. I got scared for a moment. The airport is somewhere there or what? Okay, we are back. We are landing this thing. Let's go to the checklist. Approach. Barrow is set. Seatbelts on. Minimums are set. Auto brake is set. And engine mode selector is set. Perfect. The airport is somewhere behind us. That's the airport. Perfect, had to do this. Okay, let's descend a bit faster. We will wait to get a bit of a distance. Let's start our left hand turn. Reduce our speed to 10. And we can go flaps on, speed check, flaps on. Then let's 050 to intercept the localizer as well. On the approach mode. Speed to 180. Here we are on the localizer. Okay, flaps 2, speed check, flaps 2. Should be a little bit lower. Get down. Flaps 2, speed check, flaps 2. 2,500. Speed to manage. Flaps full. Speed check, flaps full. Shut up plane. Spoilers on. Cabin is checked. We are pretty fast.
1,000.
Hopefully the airplane will slow down. I messed up the glide slope a bit. Start recording. Change the camera. Yeah, I messed up the glide slope. I thought we were above the glide slope, but we were... No, I thought we were below the glide slope, but actually we were above it, and yeah. Okay, autopilot off. My airplane, we are stable. A little bit too late to be stable, but we are.
Hundred above. 300.
Gotta butter this.
200. 100. 50. 40. 30. 20. 10. 5.
Wait, didn't butter. touchdown. Reverses, spoilers, diesel. What the heck is this on our right side? Knots is still since when does Hurghada have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 ATCs? Actually towers, not ATCs. What Amazon seems Hurghada. Come tired like Amazon. Okay. Landing lights off. Now let's taxi. Turn on deep view. Back to the cockpit. Flaps can go clean. Disarm the spoilers. One of my worst landings, but at least we made it. Up with all these towers, but yeah, we won't go to that apron. I should have paid $23 for an actual mod of this airport. Let's go on this then. Okay, parking brake is engaged. APU bleed is on. Okay, silver signs are off. Engine number 1 is off. Engine number 2 is off. Let me check something. Yeah, I have no idea what's going on with the towers. No idea. Okay, let's try this. It might spawn this entities. Did it spawn? Yes, it did. Haha. Haha. And the stairs. Alright. Oh, forgot something. Forgot the lights. Beacon turn off. Perfect. That was the flight to Hurghada. I don't know what's going on with all these towers. I don't ask me. Okay, let's put this the view like this. Okay, that was the flight. The landing was a bit terrible. It was a bit terrible. I've done better landings, but yeah, that's everything I could have done. Now I fled way too late, because I didn't want to float. That's my my nightmare. I've used to float a lot in my past landings, and now I'm not floating anymore. I'm just smashing into the ground. But it was an okay-ish landing. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And yeah, it's been an interesting live stream. It's been an interesting flight. Maybe it would have been a little bit more interesting on that sim, but yeah, I guess next time. So yeah, thank you for watching this live stream. Make sure to press the like button, to subscribe on this channel, and also press the notifications bell to not to miss any future live streams on this channel. I will probably do a live stream tomorrow. Don't know which company, what airports and stuff, but yeah, we'll see. Thank you guys for being here. Thank you guys for watching. And we will see each other on to our next slide. Bye bye.